It's Thursday, January 2nd, 2014. Good morning. I'm forecaster Mark Spencer from NeoWeather.com. We have a lot to go over. We have plenty of snow out there. Winds are also going to pick up as well. We'll have the latest snowfall estimates for you. And will we see a taste of Siberia moving into Ohio next week? Get all the details and much more starting right now. The snow has arrived this morning. It's snowing across a good portion of Ohio, and it's going to continue to snow through much of the day. Most of the snow is going to be fairly light through the day. However, there's going to be some pockets of moderate snow to occasionally heavy snow. Winds will also pick up this afternoon. That means blowing and drifting snow, as well as reduced visibilities. So if you're traveling today, it's going to be tricky, especially this afternoon for the commute home. If you're flying today, not a very good day to fly, especially out of Cleveland Hopkins, where there's currently 85 flight cancellations right now. Chicago O'Hare also has about 150 cancellations just this morning. On our Facebook page, I'm going to post some more cancellations across the country in case you are flying out. If you are, call your airline before you leave home to check on the status of your flight. We also have showers and storms across a good portion of the southeast. That's in association with a low pressure system that's been pushing off into the northeast. Now behind all this, take a look at the cold air here. Wow. There is a negative 40 at International Falls, Minnesota this morning. Very, very cold. Otherwise, we're talking anywhere from just below zero to we're below 10 degrees below zero, 20 degrees below zero in spots as well. Very, very cold air coming. We'll detail that in a 7-day forecast coming up. Across our area this morning, temperature-wise, temperatures are going to stay pretty steady today, right around 21, 22 degrees or so. You're at 22 Cleveland, 19 Akron and Canton, 20 Mansfield, 24 Dover, New Philadelphia, 17 Youngstown, and 15 up in Ashtabula. Cool spots out in Port Clinton right now at 12 degrees. You can see we have mainly light snow, but we do have some pockets of moderate snow right now. Just to the east of Ashland, over much of Wayne County, affecting Worcester, southern Medina County, Wadsworth, moving into much of Summit County, and also Stark County. Also, another band out here just to our west across Erie and Huron counties, moving east. That's going to affect Lorain County and eventually Cleveland here within the next hour or so. And under those areas, you're going to see reduced visibilities and heavier snowfall rates. We'll look at how much snow we're going to get coming up in just a moment. And also, wind chills are going to be a factor today, too. Wind chills are going to be getting much lower, maybe 10 degrees below zero later this evening. Right now, wind chills are mainly in the single digits across the area. So it feels anywhere from about 6 to about 10 degrees above zero out there right now. And we'll be talking wind chills early next week, 15, 20 degrees below zero. Stay tuned. Our high yesterday was 25 degrees, the low 19. Our average high is 35. The record high today, 66. The record low, minus 12. Will we see lows that cold coming up next week? Find out in just a moment. We had 3.9 inches of snow for yesterday, same for the month. Sunrise is at 7:53 a.m. and sunset is at 5:09 p.m. Our NEO risk for today, snow is going to get in the way. It's going to snow through much of the day. Some of it could be moderate to briefly heavy at times. It's also going to be cold, but that's not going to be the biggest factor. It's going to get windy too. That's going to bring wind chills up. We could be talking about 5 and maybe almost 10 degrees below zero, as well as blowing and drifting snow, and that is going to also create some slow travel this afternoon and this evening. Check out our Facebook fan page. I'm going to post all the flight cancellations by where they're going to go out of Cleveland here, and also some road conditions and parking bans across northeastern Ohio. So how much snow are we going to get? Well, we revised our forecast just a little bit here as things have come together. Generally still 4 to 8 inches across much of the area, generally from US Route 30 north. Now, in the snow belt east of Cleveland, so the eastern suburbs, Lake Geauga and Ashtabula County, 8 to upwards as much as possibly 12 inches of snow in the higher terrains. I don't expect a widespread 12 inches anywhere at this time. That's due to lake enhancement as the system moves through today, and also some lake effect that picks up this evening into early Friday morning. It'll shut off pretty quick, though. South of Route 32 to possibly as much as 4 inches of snow possible in that area. Some of our travel is going to be a slow go through the day. We'd love to hear your snowfall amounts in your backyard. Feel free to post them on our fan page or on Twitter, and we'll share those around as well. Our forecast for today, it's going to be a chilly one out there. High of about 21, 22 degrees. Winds will be out of the northeast. They'll eventually swing out of the north 10 to 25 miles per hour. Could gust up to 30, possibly 35 miles an hour along the lakeshore at times. Along the lakeshore is where we're going to see the gustiest winds. Inland, they'll be a little less. Snow again through the whole day here. 18 at 7 a.m., 19 by 11 a.m. Some of the snow around then could be moderate to briefly heavy. 21 at 2 p.m. and 18 by 5 p.m. Snow will start to taper off around 5 or 6 o'clock or so. Now overnight tonight, we'll see light snow through the evening. However, later on, we'll see the lake effect snow develop. And we'll have scattered lake effect snow pretty much through the night. There could be a band that sets up west of Cleveland for a short time before it moves east. We do get cold. We drop to around 10. Winds will be out of the north and eventually the northwest 10 to 20 miles per hour. So you can imagine those wind chills are going to be well below zero. Be sure to bundle up if you're going to be out tonight. Over the next 7 days, boy, we got some cold air coming. For Friday, 16 is your high. We'll see the morning lake effect snow eventually, and then we're going to gradually clear out as high pressure moves in. I think we're going to go with a sun and cloud mix, though, for Saturday, a high of 28. And Friday night's low is going to be pretty cold, so that 28 is going to feel pretty warm after a morning low of 7. More snow moves in with another system Saturday night and Sunday. This has the potential to bring us a decent amount of snow. We'll say right now generally about 6 inches, but that is still yet to be seen. Stay tuned for the very latest. Sunday's high is 28. We're going to bottom out, though, through the evening. Look at Sunday night's low, 1. Yes, we're going to see some snow as well. It's going to be lake effect. We're going to see lake effect snow Monday and Tuesday. It's going to be very windy. The winds are going to set up, I think, just right for a primary snow belt area that's going to be affected by the lake effect snow. Cold, though, Monday, a high of only 10. And then we really bottom out Monday and Tuesday night. Monday night's low, minus 12. Tuesday night's low, minus 10. And according to some of the computer model guidance, that's actually 10 degrees warmer than what they're showing. They're showing lows anywhere from negative 18 to negative 20 or so. So we'll have to keep a very close eye on it. That's some of the coldest air we've seen in over 20 years in this area. Tuesday's high is 1 with lake effect snow. Hey, it's going to be sunny for Wednesday. The high pressure is going to move in with a very balmy high of 3 degrees.